President Trump, in his own words, the secret recording, what he said about a conversation he had with Canada's prime minister. Here's ABC's chief global affairs correspondent, Martha Raddatz, tonight.
Have you always been truthful with Prime Minister Trudeau?
Thank you very much.
No boasting from President Trump today, but last night at a Missouri fundraiser, it was classic Trump. In a secret recording obtained by NBC News, telling his supporters that he was essentially winging it with Canada's Prime Minister Justin Trudeau when countering Trudeau's claims that the U.S. had no trade deficit with Canada.
Nice guy, good-looking guy comes in. Donald, we have no trade deficit. He's very proud because everybody else, you know, we're getting killed with it. So he's like, I said, wrong, Justin, you do. I didn't even know. Josh, I had no idea. I just said you're wrong. You know why? Because we're so stupid.
That got a laugh, but there was no joking today. Canada pointing to the U.S. government website that shows there is an overall surplus, not a deficit, to the tune of $12.5 billion in 2016. That did not convince the president. Instead, doubling down, tweeting this morning, we do have a trade deficit with Canada, as we do with almost all countries, some of them massive. The White House says the president was talking about only the deficit in goods with Canada, omitting the large surplus the U.S. has in services.
So let's get to Martha Raddatz with us live tonight as well. So Martha, as you report there, the Canadians pointing to our own government website and our numbers.
David, they stuck with that low-key, unfazed Canadian style, simply forwarding those statistics from the U.S. Trade Representative that show an overall surplus, factoring in both goods and services, David.
All right, Martha.
More breaking news. The White House says President Trump and Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau had their second phone call in a week to discuss those steel and aluminum tariffs imposed last week by the president. We'll hear from the Prime Minister next. Breaking tonight, the White House says President Trump and the Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau held their second phone call within the past week today, discussing those tariffs on steel and aluminum announced by the president. Canada, for now, is exempt from the tariffs. I spoke with the Canadian leader shortly before our broadcast. Prime Minister Trudeau, the new tariffs on steel and aluminum imports, Canada and Mexico are exempt pending negotiations around NAFTA. Some Canadian analysts I've read have said it's a kind of a blackmail by the U.S. Do you see it that way?
Well, I think it's something that we're dealing with. We recognize that the American side is eager to get motion forward on NAFTA. We are too, so we're glad to do it. But one of the things that I've pointed out to the president is that the steel issue, if there were tariffs brought in, it would actually make it more difficult to move forward on NAFTA. So I'm glad that we're exempt, and we're going to continue working hard together at the NAFTA table.
Does the announcement from President Trump, does it change your negotiating tactics on NAFTA at all?
We've consistently been positive and contributing in a meaningful way at the NAFTA table. We're looking for solutions for paths forward. We're negotiating in a way that stands up for Canadian interests and Canadian workers. But we also know that it's very possible to get a good win-win-win out of updating NAFTA, and that's what we're totally open to.
Do you see this as a negotiating tactic by President Trump, though?
We'll deal with it in a straightforward way. We're glad to be exempt from the tariffs. We're going to continue to work constructively and productively at the NAFTA table, and we'll just respond the way we have with focus on the work we do together and not too much worry about the rhetoric.
I know you're traveling to Canada's Steel Heartland tomorrow, meet with industry leaders and workers. I'm wondering, what is your message going to be to them? I mean, can they breathe a sigh of relief now, or should they still be concerned that their industry could be in deep peril if these tariffs go into effect?
Well, I think they can breathe a sigh of relief, both because of the exemption the president mentioned, but also because the number of folks I've spoken to in the United States who understand the level of complex integration between our two countries on steel and aluminum. I mean, you have a steel surplus with us, even though we sell a lot of steel to you anyway. There is a tremendous level of benefit. And on the national security side, we have always been incredibly integrated. are. Canadian aluminum is in your fighter jets. Canadian steel is in your tanks. There is no better security partner in the world to the United States than Canada is. So that whole issue of national security is simply off the table. We can work together in ways that benefits steel workers and aluminum workers on both sides of the border.
You know, we've seen President Trump change his mind on a number of issues, even just most recently on gun issues. He does seem to change his mind a lot. You've actually touted that as an attribute of his. I'm just wondering, though, in terms of negotiation, when the president gives you his word on something or expresses his position, do you have full confidence that he will stick by that?
He always has with me. When we've agreed on things, he's moved forward. When I spoke to him about this concern around national security in 232 a year ago in Sicily, he assured me that Canada wouldn't be part of the tariffs if they move forward. And indeed, Canada's not part of the tariffs moving forward.
Some have said that flattery or praise seem to work well when dealing with President Trump. Is that an approach that you've taken?
I think I've certainly made a point of not disrespecting him or being insulting, but I think at the same time I've demonstrated that I'm willing to stand up for Canadian workers every step of the way and Canadian interests, and I think ultimately he respects that.
Just lastly, last week President Trump accepted an invitation to meet with North Korea's leader Kim Jong-un. Do you think President Trump should meet with him, and do you have any concerns regarding the risks of a face-to-face meeting between the two?
Well, Canada has always said that of the challenge of escalation of tensions on the Korean Peninsula, diplomatic and political solutions are the way to go, not military solutions. That's why we were glad to host the Vancouver conference about a month ago to gather together a broad range of allies from around the world. We're going to continue to hope that there are political solutions, and if this meeting happens, then we hope that it leads to good things.
Prime Minister Trudeau, I appreciate your time. Thank you.
My pleasure, Anderson.